So there are a lot of elements in this one, and one of the most important elements is the enchufa with the hand slide. Now the first thing we have to go to is the crossbody lead, where you as a leader are turning underneath her right arm to your left. One, two, we give her a crossbody lead, five, six, and this is seven. Okay, so on seven, guys, you turn around. How do you do that? Well, you're stepping back in your crossbody lead, you're changing weight to your left, so all you have to do on seven is turn underneath the arm. And what is coming next is that the lady will step back and you're gonna go forward on one. And as you can see, we're building up some tension. You see, my left arm connected to her right arm, one. Now I push her forward, two, and then you go up on three. So I'm pushing myself back, actually. Let's do it again. One, two, cross, five, six, and seven. What is important, guys, is that when you turn under the arm, that you keep the hand of the lady in your own, your own frame. Because when it's in her frame, she might think it's her turn. You see? So that's why I keep the hands, whenever I want to turn, I keep the hand in my circle. So now when I turn, it's going to be very hard for her to think that it's her turn, okay? So now we build up some tension. You have to step away from her, one, and now you give her a slight push forward and left. If you just push forward, you will see her going somewhere towards the bar, okay? So you have to turn her. This is the step. Now look, I'm pushing her that way. That's the only way she will take it as a turn. If you just push forward, she will pass you by like, okay, what's next, okay? Now, as you can see, since Vanessa is holding her arm centered, I can just easily pick it up and now do what I call a reverse enchufa, okay? Look, five, six, seven, here. Just a simple turn, okay? So one more time, those first three elements, and one, two, check the hand, five, six, seven, one, two, three, and five, six, and seven. You see, we're moving from one side to the next. Now, guys, we're gonna push forward, one, and now we're gonna turn on two, three. It feels like a hook turn, but actually it's a single left turn. This is one, two, and this is three. Be sure that you keep your right hand on shoulder height. Now, guys, you have to step forward with your right foot, which might feel a little bit strange, but what you're actually going to do is you're going to lead her that way. So we're going to go five. You see, I'm taking her along. Guys, start stretching out your left arm. Six. And now, when you let go, you finish your turn on seven. Do you see my seven? It's going straight back into the line with my partner. Now, as you can see, the arms are in each other's parallel holds. You see, like her arm is straight at mine. There was actually no gap, and it's not the guys somewhere here trying to catch the hand. No, the nice thing is you're touching her shoulder and she is touching yours. Now look what happens when we step back. My hand and her hand are sliding next to each other. That's why we call it the hand slide, okay? So when we are here, you're gonna go one, two, and three. And what is important, guys, on the third count is that you take your position, so now she knows she has to do a turn in place. The moment that you get out of your hand slide, guys, and you're gonna kind of open up, she thinks she has to move that way. So you have to be sure you take your position, okay? And then comes the single right turn for the lady, and you can finish off with a crossbody lead. Okay, so let's do this again. Slowly, one and two, here we go. Five and six and seven. And one and two and three, reverse enchufa. Five and six, single left turn, guys. One and two, go forward with your right foot. Five and six and seven, hand slide. One and two, turn the lady. Five, six, seven, and one. From the other side. So again, guys, the most important thing is, in the beginning, keep her hand above your own head. Here we go. One and two and three. Five, here we go. Six, you see that? It's in my center line. And seven. And one, two, three, five, six. Single left turn, guys. One, two, step forward with your right foot. Five, six, stop on seven. You see, here we go. This is seven. Now when you step back, one, two, and three. What is important, guys, is that she feels your fingertips sliding along her arm, because now she knows, you see that? That she has to bend her fingers. If she would keep her fingers straight, There would be nothing to catch, okay? So here we go. Then you close in on the third count, finishing off with a single eye turn. You go straight into a new crossbody lead, okay? Now we can add some styling for the ladies. Here we go.
Okay, ladies, now we're going to do the combination for us. First of all, we do the combination without arm styling, and after that, I will do some lady styling for you too. Starting with a crossbody lead, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. So here only the man turns because my hand is above his head and it's not above my head. Now we go further, make sure you keep your frame, 1, 2, 3. Because you have your frame, you feel that you have a lead to make a little turn. Also, when you come back, you directly go in the middle position so you can grab your hand again. Now we're going back on 5. Make sure you're not stepping back on 6 with your right, but go straight forward, 6, 7. Yes, going further in a basic step, 1, 2, 3, to a crossbody lead, 5, 6, 7. As you can see, I make my crossbody lead with small steps because I want to end up in a position that I can get to his shoulder. If I make big steps in my crossbody lead, I probably end up like this. And then there's no slide to do anymore. So keep your crossbody lead set small so you end up with your left hand on his shoulder. Going back on 1, 2, 3, to a right turn, 5, 6, 7. So we're going to do it again, but then from this position without a crossbody lead. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 5. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, small steps. 5, 6, 7, basic. 1, 2, right turn. 5, 6, 7. Okay, now it's time for some arm styling. The first styling will be from the part that we did a crossbody lead, ending up on the other side, going to a styling with our left arm. So you get 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. From here on, you can already start your styling. We're going to do it with our left arm, going out and then back up, finishing in the middle position. Remember, when we are on the other sides, it's important to have your hands in the middle position again, so you don't have like 8 counts to do your styling. Just do it like 3 counts at max. So here we go. 1, 2, back in the middle position because he needs my hand. Going further, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, stop, 3. So now we go to the next one. We go into a crossbody lead. As soon as I step forward on 5, I bring out my right arm, 5. Then I go further on 6, I bring my right hand to my left hand. And finishing on 7, with my left hand on the shoulder and still my right hand on my left hand. As soon as we go to the basic step backwards, we have with our left hand the slide, but we're also going to slide with our right hand over my own arm. So here we go. Slide over your own arm. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. This is something you need to practice a couple of times to get used to doing those things with your arm. If you want to do a little bit more lady styling at the end part, you can do, instead of going in a slide directly to your middle position, you can also choose to go slide in a loop, or even more advanced, slide shoulder, shoulder, from the backward to front. Yeah, so you have 3 options. From your slide back to the middle position, from your slide in a normal loop, or from your slide go shoulder, shoulder, from the back to the front, directly to your turn, 5, 6, 7. Okay, ladies, we have a little alone time, so here we go. I'm going to explain you exactly how you can do your hands in a nice position to get your styling for this combination right, and to get like used to it working with your arms. So the first styling that we did was in the first part of the combination after the crossbody lead. When you bring out your arm from the middle position, go out, go up, go behind your hair, back in the middle position. So as you can see, it's a motion that keeps on going back to the middle position. So that's the first one. I will also do it from this side. So the first one was the styling with your left arm. From the middle position, you go out, go up, finish behind your head, back to the middle position. And again, out, up, behind your hair, back. Then the second one, that was after the crossbody lead where we go to the slide where I have my left hand on the shoulder of the man. In the crossbody lead, on count five, we're going to do a styling with our right arm. So it's going out, and then you bring your right hand on top of your left hand and slide it over your own arm and back. So it was out, to your own hand, slide over your own arm, and back in the middle position. Do it from this side. We go out on five, to my hand, slide over my arm, back in the middle position. And again, out on five, on my hand, slide over my arm, back in the middle position. Of course, you need to practice this also with your steps. But first, doing your styling only with your hands is maybe easier to get used to it. And then doing your steps also will make you more advanced with dancing with your styling. So we had three options for the hand slide. So the first one was out on five, on your hand, slide, middle position. Then if you want to do a little bit more, we can go out on five, on your hand, slide to a normal loop. Yeah, we do the second one again. So we go out on five, on your hand, slide to a normal loop. Then, for the more advanced styling, we did a styling that was out on five, on your hand, from your left shoulder to your right shoulder, bring up your elbow, and go from the back part of your head to the front middle position. So again, out on five, to your hand, slide, left shoulder, right shoulder, elbow up, from the back to the front, in the middle position.